Hey everyone, welcome back. Today I would like to talk about Lost Words Beyond the Page. I'm about a few hours into the game so far, and I have to say I'm very much enjoying it. The footage that you are going to see while I talk about this is all very early stuff. I didn't want to spoil anything for anybody. It's a very interesting game, and I have to say, an emotional one. If it's something that, if you've recently experienced a loss in your life, then I don't know that you would want to play this, or maybe you need to play this. I'm not sure because I haven't finished the game yet, but as I was playing, there were definitely moments that made me feel like really, really sad. Kind of like the beginning to Up. You know how that made you feel? Kind of like that. So I'm still very early on in the game, but I am enjoying it. And it's a kind of game that's extremely unique. Let's see how Sketchbook Games, the developers, describe Lost Words Beyond the Page. They say that Lost Words is an atmospheric puzzler set between the pages of a diary and Fantasyland. So I'm going to stop there for a second and address what they are saying there. The game is actually telling two stories simultaneously, and each story has its own art style along with it. So we'll start with the pages of a diary. When you're looking at the pages of a diary, the game has this cool, I don't know, watercolor feel to it, like somebody is writing in a journal, and it's almost like they are writing in the journal as you are playing this drawing that is in the journal, which is something I always, like when I was a kid and I said that I wanted to make a video game, I always kind of wanted to make something that looked like you were playing a drawing. And I'm sure that there's others like that, but this one feels very unique. So you are going through this journal as this little black and white character. And then there's like these little watercolor scenes that you get to see as this girl tells a story that is very much based in the real world. As you're doing that, some words or objects will be highlighted on the pages of the journal, and you can use your right stick and your right trigger to grab those things and move them around and manipulate the journal in order to give yourself either platforms or to uncover clues or things like that. It's really cool. Now, as you go through and you get to a certain story beats, there's like little doorways that will take you to the next page of the journal, but when you get to the end of certain story beats, those doorways will, instead of being black and white, be color, and that will transport you out of the journal and into the fantasy world, which has a wildly different aesthetic. Still very painterly feeling, but it doesn't feel so much like watercolors to me. It's really, really gorgeous, and I think that the art in this game is fantastic. Early on in the journal portion, the girl who is writing the journal is talking about the fact that she would like to be a writer, and you get to choose some of the things that affect the fantasy world, basically like the color of the cloak that the person wears and that kind of stuff. So those things are implemented into the fantasy world, and then you play as this character who has the ability to use words in order to manipulate the environment. And while that sounds very, very similar to what's happening in the journal, it's implemented in a very different way. You can use the, like, you can open up your magic book and maybe grab the word repair to fix something, or grab the word rise to make something float, or grab the word break to break something that is in your way. The story is written by Rihanna Pratchett. She's an English video game writer. She's also a journalist. She worked on games like Heavenly Sword, Overlord, Mirror's Edge, and Tomb Raider, as well as Rise of the Tomb Raider. And she is also the daughter of fantasy writer Terry Pratchett, which is pretty cool, interesting. The writing is really good. And the voice acting that I've seen so far, it's just one voice actor, but it sounds awesome, and she's doing a wonderful job. Basically, you go through the journal part of the story and find out what's going on in this little girl's life who wants to become a writer. And then at the same time, you are playing through a story that she's writing in order to help distract her from some things that are happening in her life that, you know, you might want to be distracted from. It's very, very interesting and wonderfully written. And I can't lie, as I was playing this, there were parts very early on where I was like, oh, that's awful. I'm kind of choked up. So far, I'm enjoying the game. I hate to say that it's not a game, because it is a game, but it's really more of an interactive storytelling experience, which I don't know why that makes it not a game in my book. I guess it doesn't. It is a game, but it's not a traditional game. And if that's what you're looking for, if you're looking for a traditional game, then you might want to look elsewhere. But if you're looking at a narrative-driven, interesting story with very, very cool artwork on both sides of the page, no pun intended, then Lost Words Beyond the Page by Sketchbook Games is very, very cool. And I think it looks gorgeous on Google Stadia. It plays really well. It does not push Google Stadia as far as power, but that's okay, because not every game has to push a system to its absolute limit. If you don't have a Nintendo Switch and you don't have Animal Crossing to kind of break up the ridiculous over-the-top violence of Doom, then this is definitely something that you could play on Google Stadia to give you a break. Like, this is a relaxing game, kind of in the same vein of Animal Crossing as a relaxing game. Whereas when I play Doom, I like, there are times when I finish a level and my teeth hurt because I'm clenching my jaw so hard because the game is so intense. This is not that kind of experience. This is the exact opposite. And it's a wonderful kind of palate cleanser between white knuckle crazy levels of Doom Eternal. So if you're looking for something very, very different to give you a break from the heart-pounding insanity that is Doom Eternal, then I think the relaxing, laid-back puzzle work of Lost Words might be something for you.